Good morning. In this lecture video, I'm going to explain application of SR latch. So in the previous videos, I explained what is SR latch, that is set and reset latch. So in this video, I'm going to explain application of SR latch. A simple but important application is a switch debouncer. Application of SR latch as a switch debouncer. See, the common problem involved in the switches is occurrence of a contact bounce. That means, see, it is a switch. Okay, so this is terminal. So now it is in B. Okay, when you change it to A, so it will move to A, but it will not settle there. It will not immediately settle. It moves to A and leaves the contact. Again moves to A and leaves the contact. That is called as contact bounce. See, let's see the corresponding waveform. Initially, A is 0 because no contact. And B is V. That V will represent plus 5 volt or 12 volt. Okay, na? So, because contact is at B. Right, na? When it changes from B to A becomes 5 volt, but again leaves the contact. When it leaves the contact, it becomes 0. Again it will go there, again leaves the contact, again it will go there, and then it is settled, and then it is settled. Yeah. But here, see, when it leaves the contact B, it becomes 0, and it is always 0 because it will never come back to B. It will go to A and lose the contact, again go A and lose the contact, but it will never come to B. So this portion is called as contact bounce. Similarly, after some time it is settled at A. Now when it leaves A, it becomes 0, but it will touches B and leaves, again touches and leaves. After some time it is settled at B. So this is the contact bounce when changing from A to B, and this is the contact bounce from changes from B to A. This is called contact bounce, and this can be removed using SR latch. Here plus V volt refers logic 1 and count refers logic 0. So now this is the debouncer circuit. See, here to A and B we connected on SR latch. I mean, A terminal is connected to S and B terminal is connected to R, and then it is connected through resistor ground. Okay, now let's analyze this. This is the waveform. Right, see here, corresponding to this, see, now it is A, that is S is equal to 1. Correct, and B connected to R, so R is equal to 0. So since S is equal to 1, Q becomes 1, and then when it leaves, S becomes 0, again R becomes 0. This means maintains the same state. Now it touches S becomes 1, so it maintains the set state. When it becomes 0, both are 0, maintain the same state. So this contact bounce is eliminated. Similarly, see, at this moment, A 0, that means R 0. And here B 1, that means R 1. So when R 1 means reset, so Q becomes 0. And this moment, again here R0, S0 maintains the same state. So this portion is avoided, eliminated. So we are getting output of A from output Q, and for B volt from Q bar. Clear, no? So with a simple SR latch, we can eliminate contact bounce. So whenever the central contact of switch is not connected to either of the terminals A and B, so as I said, no, it lose the contact and just gonna. So pull down resistor provides logic 0 to both S and R, as I explained in the waveform, no. As I explained this waveform, no. So here, when center contact of the switch is not connected to either of the terminal A or B, the pull down transistor, sorry, resistor provides logic 0 to both S and R terminals. Thus, SR latch remains in the same state. It is simple but important application of switch debouncer. Okay, more number of time question is appeared to explain a switch debouncer. Okay. So, hence SR latch eliminates the effect of contact points. Now, we will see another latch, S bar R bar latch. So, you see, it's also called as a NAND gate latch. So, SR latch is also called as a NOR gate latch. S bar R bar latch is also called as a NAND gate latch, since it is consists of cross coupled NAND gate. And remember here, so Q bar corresponds, S bar correspond to Q and R bar correspond to Q bar. Yeah. Yeah. So it consists of cross coupled NAND gates. And this is second structure where NAND gate is replaced with AND and NOT gate. So from the logic diagram, again, if both are 1-1, I mean S bar R bar is equal to 1-1. This S bar R bar is equal to 1-1. Okay. It becomes a bistable element. So as you know, if one input to the AND gate is fixed to 1, output depends on other gate. So other, if it is 0, that will be connected here. So this other input is from output of NOT gate. Again here. So this other input is from output of NOT gate. So it becomes cross-coupled NOT gate. Okay. That means if one input to the AND gate is fixed to 1, output of other gate, output of NAND gate is depends on other. So if other input is 0, output is 0. If other input is 1, output is 1. Okay. Thus, device has two stable state. And this is the logic symbol. See here, we use SR. But here, this bubble indicates complemented. S bar, R bar. Here it is Q bar. Here we use Q, but output bubble. This indicates complemented output. So this bubble indicates inputs are complemented. This indicates output is complemented, and this indicates inputs are complemented. Okay. So let's verify the operation. First case, when S bar R bar is equal to 1-1. Okay. So what happens? 1-1. See, S bar is equal to 1, R bar is equal to 1. If one input to the NAND gate is 1, output depends on other gate. Output depends on other gate. So what is the other gate? It is Q. Again here also, S bar is 1, its output depends on this input, and this is Q, and we don't know what is Q and Q bar. So assume Q is equal to 1, Q bar is equal to 0. So Q bar is equal to 0, no, that is connected to upper NAND gate. So if one input is 0, output of NAND gate is 1. So output of upper NAND gate, that is Q, is equal to 1. Then since Q bar is equal to 0, S bar is equal to 1. Then output of lower NAND gate, Q bar is equal to 0, because inputs Q is equal to 1, R bar is equal to 1. Both the inputs to the NAND gate is 1-1, or its output is a 0. So that means same present state. So we assumed 1-0, we got 1-0. So same as present state. Again, if we assume present state Q is equal to 0, Q bar is equal to 1, Q is equal to 0 is connected to lower NAND gate. So output of lower NAND gate, that is Q bar is equal to 1. Since inputs are Q is equal to 0, R bar is equal to 1. And this Q bar is equal to 1 is connected to upper NAND gate. So upper inputs to the upper NAND gate is R bar, Q bar is equal to 1. S bar is equal to 1, so its output is 0. Since inputs are Q bar is equal to 1, S bar is equal to 1. Okay. So same as present state. So when both are 1-1, same as present state. Next, Next condition, when S bar is equal to 1, R bar is equal to 0. Second case. Yeah, so here R bar is equal to 0, no? That is connected to lower NAND gate. So regardless of other input, second input, output of lower NAND gate, that is Q bar is equal to 1, since R bar is equal to 0. And this Q bar is equal to 1 is connected to upper NAND gate, and another input S bar is equal to 1. So output is a 0. So output of upper NAND gate, inputs to the upper NAND gate both are 1-1. Hence output is a 0. So the latch being reset. Suppose if R bar becomes 1, no, then inputs to the lower NAND gate R bar is equal to 1 and Q is equal to 0. So its output is 1. And then inputs to the upper NAND gate are recent Q bar value 1 and S bar is equal to 1. So output is a 0. So same as present state. So when S bar is equal to 1, R bar is equal to 0, it enters into reset state. Okay. So next condition, when S bar is equal to 0, R bar is equal to 1. Okay. Again, S bar is equal to 0, which is connected to upper NAND gate. So regardless of second input, output of upper NAND gate is 1, that is Q is equal to 1. Then inputs to the lower NAND gate, Q is equal to 1 and R bar is equal to 1. So hence its output is a 0, that is Q bar is equal to 0. Okay, so the latch being set because Q is equal to 1. Now again, if S bar becomes 1, input to the upper NAND gate becomes S bar is equal to 1, Q bar is a 0, so its output is 1. Then input to the lower NAND gate, Q is equal to 1, R bar is equal to 1, so its output is a 0. Same as present state, no change. So when S bar is equal to 0, R bar is equal to 1, it enters into set state. See here, R is equal to R bar is equal to 0, R is equal to 1, so reset state. See, S bar is equal to 0, S is equal to 1, so set state. Clear, no? Yeah. Again, when both 0, 0, when both 0, 0, what happens when both 0, 0, both the output becomes 1. That is, Q is equal to, Q bar is equal to 1. Right, so they are not complementary. Again, difficulties encountered in both returns to 1 simultaneously. Okay, so now if any one becomes a 1, no problem. So when suppose if S bar becomes 1, R bar is still 0, and both Q is equal to 1, Q bar is equal to 1. So now R bar is equal to 0, no, that is connected to lower NAND gate. So output of lower NAND gate is 1 since R bar is equal to 0. And input to the upper NAND gate becomes Q bar is equal to 1, S bar is equal to 1, so its output is a 0. So it enters into reset state. So as we are expecting, when R bar is equal to 0, we are expecting reset state. So reset state is entered. Suppose if the latch being reset. Similarly, if R bar becomes 1, S bar is still 0, and present state Q is equal to 1, Q bar is equal to 1. So here S bar is equal to 0, no, that is connected to upper NAND gate. So output of upper NAND gate Q is equal to 1 since S bar is equal to 0. So then inputs to the lower NAND gates are R bar is equal to 1, Q is equal to 1. Then its output is 0, that is Q bar is equal to 0. So the latch being reset. See, whenever S bar is equal to 0, we are expecting set state. So set state is entered, that is Q is equal to 1. Clear, na? So this we indicate forbidden state, both output becomes 1-1. So 1 star. In SR latch, we represent a 0 star. Here we represent 1 star. Again, if as I explained, in SR latch, if both inputs turning to 1 simultaneously, the device may enter into metastable state, and it should be avoided because for this reason and along with the fact they are not complementary, it is regarded as a forbidden input condition. And from the table, see, 0 is the active. See, if R bar is equal to 0, R is equal to 1, reset state. See, if S bar is equal to 0, S is equal to 1, set state. So, 0 serves as an activation signal of the device. Also, again, S bar, R bar are asynchronous or direct inputs. Clear, na? So, we'll continue in the next video. Thank you.